over here at RPM Racing in Connecticut. Me, my son, and his friend, we're gonna get on go-karts and race each other. I'm gonna cook these young boys. And look, beyond this point, we're not allowed to have wine or ketchup, apparently. It's a random combination. Are you ready to get cooked up?
Bro, you don't stand a chance.
You're going down.
All these nights of Pedley Mario Kart have escalated to this point.
In order to race, we have to dress like we're robbing a bank here. What do you call these things?
Shiesties.
We're wearing our shiesties. I feel like a ninja.
If you ain't first to the last.
Cruising, baby. I'm cruising. My fastest lap yet.
Must be skirt out. Hey, how did I do? Did you see my score?
Yeah, dead last.
No, whatever. How does it feel to be cooked by Daddy Cooks?
It's actually not fair at all.
Number one. Yeah. Yeah, I'm number one. I am in Los Angeles, more specifically Santa Monica. I'm in town to actually shoot an ad for State Farm. Whenever I do stuff like this, I try to come a day early or stay a day late and get a bunch of videos shot with other creators. I'm planning on seeing some old friends, making some new friends, and I'm gonna take y'all along on the journey with me today. But before we do all that, can we just enjoy the view one last time? I mean, come on. California never misses. Never misses. All right, first up here on the Santa Monica Pier is I call this dude my day one. All right, so listen, I'm asking creators, successful people like yourself, what advice would you give to other creators?
Be yourself, do it for love, follow your gut, and just go for whatever idea you have, just do it.
You heard it from the man himself right there.
She see what I'm on. Anytime you wanna get it, you can hit my phone. Energy is here, we gon' shake the room. You can see it clear, this her favorite tune. She so fly, and she shine like a chandelier. She can't go, not tonight, cause I need her here.
Okay, stop number two on the tour here of LA. Probably have seen these guys. A couple of y'all know B-Dash and Miranda. You guys have approximately 4 bagillion followers between y'all. What advice would you give to aspiring young creators?
First, you gotta find your niche, and then by doing that, you gotta keep making videos. Like, at the end of the day, that's what it takes. Just make videos and then see what people like.
I would say just being consistent, and then also making sure that your videos look the best quality possible. You don't need a big camera to do that. You can set up your phone. Just make sure the lighting looks good so that your content looks professional.
Oh, thank y'all, that's good advice. Also, I'm kind of mad that B-Dash is like 6 years younger than me and I look like his grandfather.
No.
But that's okay. No, we're just filming videos on Hollywood Boulevard, me and Isaiah, and this guy.
And then somehow we ended up in red carpet.
How'd that happen? I don't know. Hey, you hang out with Vic, you get into places. That's how it goes.
Wine.
Girl, sent you hallelujah. Girl, sent you hallelujah. Girl, sent you hallelujah. Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you. Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you. Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you. Saturday night and we in the spot. Don't believe me, just watch.
I'm asking everybody that I'm collabing with today, what advice do they have for young, aspiring, new creators?
Advice number one, have something good to create.
don't just create, because it's like the trendy thing. And then once you have something to create, just keep creating, whether you're getting millions of views or getting 2 views. And like, if it takes you a year, great. If it takes you 5 years, also great. You just gotta keep going. Don't look at the results, just focus on the craft.
Show them the pose that you were in on the red carpet, because you look like you belong.
Yo, I legit hit one of these, and I said, I don't know what I'm doing.
It looked good though. It looked good though.
Okay, last but not least, look at this.
Hello.
I'm back with Merrick. Hi, Merrick. What's your advice for an aspiring creator?
Find a niche, something that no one else is doing. It could be a combination of hobbies or something else. For me, it's dancing and visual effects. No one was doing that. And then take that niche and add it to trends. So do TikTok trends, but throw your own spin on it. That is the best advice I can give, I think.
Slick back. No, no, slick back. That's what I said. Slick back.
What a trip out to California. I am back in New York City. Glad to be back where it's a little less scenic, much cooler, but it's home. And home is where the heart is, right? So it is after Thanksgiving, and it is officially the Christmas season, guys. Can't believe it. Officially the Christmas season. I'm actually thinking about dropping some new hoodies, doing another hoodie drop here. This would be one of them. Today's forecast, 100% sturdy. This would be like one of 4 designs. So I did a hoodie drop like 3 years ago and it went well. So let me know if you or someone you love might like one of these hoodies for Christmas, and I may have to do a drop for you. Otherwise, this is the time of the year when it just gets dark real early for no reason, and it's super depressing. I hate this time of the year. I mean, I love Christmas, but I just hate that it gets so dark so early. So if you suffer with seasonal depression, you're not alone. I'm right there with you, my goodness. And speaking of the Christmas season, I've been eating like it's the Christmas season. I went nuts on Thanksgiving. I had like a full pumpkin pie, a full apple pie over the 3 or 4 days that I was off. I ate all the cookies and man, I'm paying for it. I just checked my body fat percentage and I'm back up to 14%. I was doing so good for so long, and here we go. So I told you guys, it's a struggle with me and sugar. It's up and down. One of these days, I'm gonna get it down and keep it down and curb my sugar cravings. But until then, I need you guys to help keep me accountable in the comments. Keep asking me if I'm laying off of sugar. Keep questioning if my body fat percentage is down, because I read all the comments and it definitely helps. All right, so keep doing that for me. And, you know, like I said, just trying to end this year on a strong note. It's been a good year. It's been a tough year, but a good year. And I'm trying to end things on a strong note. In 2 days, the Brooklyn Nets invited me to dance with the dance team at the halftime show. So that's my next big project. That's the next thing I've got to get ready for. I've got a rehearsal dance tomorrow with the team, and then the day after that I'm gonna dance with them. And that's one of those things that's super exciting. I'm honored, flattered, and I can't wait to do it. But it's also one of those things that's super anxiety inducing. Like, dancing on a court in front of thousands and thousands of people that are actually in front of you and not watching through a TV screen or a computer screen is crazy. But it's like a catch-22, as is all of this social media stuff. Like, if I'm doing it, it's stressing me out. And if I'm not doing it, it's stressing me out. You know, I'm wondering, I should be doing it, or why aren't people inviting me to stuff? So that's just how it goes. That's the treadmill of life. So I'm gonna do my best to bring it, and I'll try to vlog my Brooklyn Nets experience for y'all so you can see what that's all about. So yeah. Here we go. Christmas, 'tis the season. Help keep me accountable, guys. And above all, keep doing the things, right? So keep liking, subscribing, commenting, turning on the notifications, sharing. I appreciate each and every one of you guys. Thanks for watching this video. If you're watching this now, thanks for watching the video all the way through. And above all, keep spreading sunshine. See you next time.